Loaded with power as the heaviest member of the family, this is the Yonex VCORE Pro 97H330. Endorsed by Stan Wawrinka, this racket comes with plow-through and feel. With a slightly thicker beam, some small tweaks to the geometry of the shaft, and 2G NOM, this racket snaps back more efficiently during impact compared to previous models. At 12.3 ounces strung, this racket packs a punch for experienced players. It will feel rock solid and stable against big hitters and pairs with a 16x19 string pattern for great access to spin. Normally this racket falls right into my wheelhouse, but I struggled a little bit during this play test. That swing weight is well over 340 and it was a little too much for me often on the court. I really, really struggled to go cross court. I found I was hitting a little late. I needed to prepare so early and sometimes that's just not in the cards for me. I do have a fast, long swing, so if I was slightly off with my timing, it really didn't fare well for my game. I did notice though, compared to my racket of choice, it felt really flexible. I had much more feel, felt more connected to the ball for sure. So I did appreciate that. I just really was struggling to get around the ball consistently with this one. On the flip side, at night, I found it to be very stable and I really could execute my volleys successfully. And so that made me want to come to net and finish my points there since I was having some issues with consistency off the ground. Returns were a little bit of a struggle for me as well. There were a few returning sessions where I just could not find the court. So that was rough. But on serves, I really did appreciate what this racket could offer, as once I got the racket swinging, it packed a powerful first serve. And that was effective. So if I could just serve big and win points right off the bat, that was fine. But otherwise, this one was just a little bit beefy for me.
I've been waiting for this racket to come out for a couple of months now, so I was really excited to get on court and hit. And I think Yonex delivered in a big way. They thickened the beam a little bit and added the swing weight on average. And I felt like that gave a nice bump in power to the frame. From the baseline, I could drive through the ball really nicely, and I felt like the racket was doing most of the work for me. I did struggle on the forehand side with an exaggerated buggy whip motion, but as long as I kept my strokes a little bit more linear, the 16x19 pattern really performed well, and I could hit nice topspin. Up at net, just like every other update in this VCORE Pro line, I had nice touch and could really punch through the ball. So I was really happy there. Maneuverability was lacking just a little bit with the heft of the frame overall. And that was the same on the serve as well. As soon as the racket went over my head, I really had to focus on my timing and contact point to really snap through. But again, results were great. When all that came together, it produced a nice big serve. So if you're a player that is looking for a really hefty frame and loves swinging big, I definitely recommend this for you.
I had to break out this Yonex Polo today. I only do this on special occasions, but talking about this new Yonex VPRO 97330 definitely qualifies to have the shirt on. Overall, we gotta talk about the beam width. This is still a traditional frame, kind of an energy absorbing frame, but the extra beam width doesn't give it that modern energy return, but you're definitely getting more power per swing. Yonex has decided to kind of up that already beefy swing weight from the 330s into the 340s, so stability, this thing's not just rock solid, it's boulder solid. You're not gonna budge it at the baseline at all. Overall spin, easy to access, depth, everything was great. In terms of its overall weight and swing weight for a lot of players, I would say it's a long swing path type of racket. So it's really gonna complement that player that likes that longer swing path. Like I said, the serve, everything was just rock solid. It may be a little bit out of my ideal spec range, but it's something to reach for as just one of the best play tests of the last couple weeks. Lastly, I want to call out the Jazzercise paint scheme. I really enjoy it as well. This has been some of the most enjoyable 2 weeks of play testing I've had in a while.
This heavy version of the VCORE Pro has always been a beast no matter which version you hit. And just like the previous version, this one just comes through the ball with a ton of mass. I found the dense string pattern version to be a little bit above my preferred spec. This one is way above it. It works well for me on a long straight swing, as long as I keep the backswing very compact and then just go through the ball in a very linear path. Racket works well, love it at net, super solid. My favorite, like with the dense string pattern version, was probably the serve was my favorite stroke, just because I can use the mass of the racket the most on that one and just get the ball moving through the court really nicely. And so it was a good serve and volley racket for me, although not a great doubles racket just because I struggled to react quickly with it when I was in the midcourt, low pickup volleys. If I wanted to flick an angle, that shot was really not on the table for me with this racket, just too much mass for me to get moving. But if I kind of had the mentality of playing like I do when I play with a heavy, really heavy wood racket, I was okay. Just kept my backswing to a minimum, let the racket go through the ball and hit long, straight swings that way. I found it to work well, but really kind of out of my spec range.
We strung up our playtest racket with Yonex Poly Tour Rev in the new purple color at 52 pounds, as well as a few other string setups. For more information about this racket and many others, please visit us at Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.